Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Today we have a topic with us is Net Realizable Value, NRV. Net Realizable Value is used in inventory, the most probable place where it is used. See, it is written NRV is a total amount a company should expect to receive once its assets are sold or disposed of. It is a total amount company should expect to receive its asset, that can be inventory, that can be tangible assets, and they are sold or disposed minus any cost to come from the disposable or sale. Now, the first thing that we will study is what is the NRV? What is net realizable value? See, as we discussed in the dialog box, it is the value of the asset excluding a reasonable estimate of cost. So I'll just write value of asset less cost, okay, with the disposal of the assets or the eventual sale, so which is realized or deprived upon the sale of that asset, and it is basically the net realizable value. So it is commonly used in the context of, as I told you in the very beginning, inventory valuation and count receivables. Okay, now I'll take you to the steps to calculate the NRV. The step one goes over here as, first of all, you will need to determine the market value of the asset. Once you do that, the second step will go, you know, list down all the costs associated with the process of selling. That includes transportation, insurance, productions, testing, tax, miscellaneous expenditures. Just go for it. Step three, calculate the NRV. NRV is equal to your market value of the asset less the selling cost of the asset. Just do this and you will get your answer. Okay, I'll take you the second part over here as the NRV's example part. Let's say there's a company called XYZ and they are trying to get rid of some of its outdated phones and is expecting to sell them at, let's say, $5,000 to a local buyer, but it must pay $240 to have them shipped and insured. Like, I'll list down some of the, like, $5,000 to local buyer, and they need to pay closely to $240 so that, you know, it can be insured and, you know, it can be shipped. And another $40 they need to pay to complete the paperwork. So the telephone is NRV can be calculated as 5,000 less 240 less 40. That gives you 4,720. Right. Now, the next point of discussion with us is NRV in inventory valuation. Now, NRV is a conservative method, which means that the accountant should post the transaction that does not overstate the value of the asset. The value of the assets and that the potentially generated less profit. So for valuing asset, it usually requires a certified public accountant, which is known as CPAs, to do the job, as it involves a lot of judgment on this part. So on their part, so let us take an example to understand this in a detailed format. Let's say this is year one, and in year one process, company ABC has an inventory having inventory I2 having a cost of, let's say, $70. Okay, and the market value of that inventory is $200. This is the writing over here. This is your cost. This is going to be your market value. That is 200, right? So over here, your NRV is going to how much? NRV is going to be 200 less 70. And let's say to sell that inventory, you require $30. So selling cost is, let's say, $30. So 200 minus 70 minus 30, that's 70, in total $100, right? So since the cost of the inventory is 70 here, which is lower than the NRV, that is 100 here, we value the inventory on the balance sheet at 70, cost or NRV, whichever is lower, right? So on the balance sheet, what price will go as 70, whichever is lower. Now let's take year two. Now the market value of the same inventory, let's say it declines to $150 market value. Okay, now the cost and preparation cost to sell that inventory remains the same at $70. That is the selling cost, $70 and $30 respectively. So now your NRV is going to be how much? It's going to be 150 minus 70 minus 30, and that will give us answer as 50. Now, since the cost of the inventory is 70 on the balance sheet in the year one, right, which is higher than the NRV, that is 50. So the value of the inventory on the balance sheet, it will be at the balance sheet, will be inventory, will be at NRV, that is 50. So inventory will be written down. Inventory will be, there will be a write down in the inventory, which will be 70 minus 50, that is 20. So on what will be the effects? See, on the asset side, there will be a reduction of $20 on inventory write downs. Then on the liability side, no effect. Now on the shareholders' equity side, there will be decline of $20 flow through the income statement, because your P&L will decline. So your reserves and surplus will decline to the extent of $20. So in this context, the net realizable value of the inventory, it is important to understand that the company using retail or probably FIFO method, you know, would probably not use the NRV of the lower of the cost method, but would rather use a net realizable inventory or lower the cost of market value. It is worth that the adjustments can be made for each item in inventory or for the aggregate of the entire NRV to the lower of the cost NRV. So one curtail down, the inventory account becomes the new biases for the reporting purpose and valuation going forward. In case of the US GAAP, does not permit a write-up or write-downs reported in the prior year, unlike the international reporting standards, even if the NRV for the inventory has been recovered. Right, now the NRV of the, we'll try and understand the NRV of the account receivable. See, the NRV is actually the amount is expected to turn into cash. Now, account receivable, AR minus, you know, any credit balance that gives you NRV, which can also be expressed as debit balance in the asset account. So like, for instance, if the debit balance in the account receivable is standing at $10,000 and have the credit balance that will be standing at $800, and then $9,200 is the resulting of the NRV of the account receivable. Finally, let me make conclusions on this particular topic. See, NRV is the total amount of the company that should expect to receive once its assets are sold or disposed of, minus cost that comes from its disposal or sale. So this method is very useful for accountant, as it allows them to follow the conservative principle of accounting while reporting the assets on the balance sheet. So thank you everyone for joining the session. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you everyone. Cheers.